JC,
Alana, Pepin, Rona, Josh, my list,
Blaine,
the party,
Carrie,
Fred,
you.
And welcome to the Mickey Mouse Club. It's Wednesday, anything can happen day. And to prove anything can happen, we've got the party here singing their song, Coulda, Shoulda, Woulda.
And with some part two of our new Mouse Club movie, Secret Bodyguard.
And we'll be welcoming back our feature people, Warren Eckstein, to tell us all about bugs.
But first, for the brokenhearted, if you want to know what's in your future, pay a visit to Madame Lasagna.
Welcome to Madame Lasagna. I know all, I see all. You pay all.
Oh, right.
Sit, and I will gaze into my crystal ball.
Cool.
I see a beautiful girl that you dump, and a life filled with loneliness, and the nagging feeling that she was the only one for you.
You know, you're right. I was a real jerk.
Say that again.
I mean, I see a desire to reunite.
That's amazing. That's exactly what I was thinking. How do you know?
Of course you tell
her. Oh, right. Well, she told me. How can I get her back?
It's getting cloudy here. I'm not so sure if she wants you back.
Yeah.
Hey, I bet you can't guess what this weird contraption is. Well, wait. First, let's see if our friends at the Disney MGM Studios theme park could guess what it is.
It's kind of weird. I think I could use it as some kind of laser.
It looks kind of scary to me. I would not want to come in contact with this object.
I can use this to pick lint off my shirt. I just put it, focus it in on the lamp, and pinch it, pick it up. Now I can look at it, see what it is.
I would call this the secret spy letter reader.
Could be a metal pterodactyl.
I don't know what it would be.
Well, those were all good guesses, but they're wrong. Believe it or not, the technical name for this funny-looking thing is helping hand, and it's used for soldering fine wire. Now watch. If I take a piece of radio wire and I put it in here, and I take another one and I put it in here, then I can look through this magnifying glass and get a closer peek at what I'm doing. Isn't that cool? Well, thanks to all our friends who gave it their best shot.
An eighth of a teaspoon of iodine. 1 milliliter of castor oil. And boric acid.
Coming soon from the director who terrorized you with the gingerbread man and made you fear homework with his desk of the darned. Can't hide from Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde and Go Seek.
Come out, wherever you are.
Now playing at a theater near you. Check local listings for showtimes.
Time for part two of our new club movie, Secret Bodyguard. Meeting Ernie Reyes Jr. on Monday was great.
Yeah, he does have some incredible moves.
And you guys at home are going to be seeing a lot more in the next episode of Secret Bodyguard. Here's part two right now.
Now it's done. Let's begin. Maybe he wants to give you a reward for saving his life.
And save his life?
You just saved his life. Come on, Ernie. I saw the whole thing. One guy had a knife.
Oh,
my dad, Belmont's one of the richest guys in town. He'll probably want to give you like $1,000 or something.
Have to give me anything.
Oh, yeah, but why else would he want to see you?
I've
been doing a little checking up on you, Ernie. Of course, I witnessed your martial arts skills at the restaurant the other night. But I've learned that you're a very impressive young man in other ways.
Thank you.
Senior's honor student at Westridge High. One of the youngest 4th-degree black belts in the country. Raised by your aunt and uncle after your parents died. You are planning on going to college next year.
Yeah.
Very impressive. I'll get right to the point, Ernie. My daughter Brittany wants to attend Westridge High this semester. I have to admit that makes me very nervous. See, my daughter's led a rather sheltered life. She's not used to doing things on her own, unsupervised. So if she is to attend public high school, then I'm going to need someone to keep an eye on her, to make sure she doesn't get into trouble.
What do you mean, like a babysitter?
Sort of. I think you're just the man for the job.
I don't understand that.
I want to hire you. I want you to look after her for me while she's at Westridge. I want you to be her protector.
I don't know.
Colleges. They're expensive, right? You make, what, about $70 a week at the restaurant?
About that, but it's only part-time.
Yes, well, I had something more like this in mind.
A week?
Yes, well, it's more like full-time. I want you to pick my daughter up in the morning, take her to school, bring her back in the afternoon. To make absolutely certain that nothing happens to her. So, think you can handle that?
Sure. Doesn't sound too hard.
Well, you don't know Brittany. I want you to start first thing Monday morning. Oh, there's just one more thing. I would hate for word to get back to my daughter that I'd hired a babysitter to look out for her. So don't mention to any of your friends at school about our arrangement. Understood?
I'm sorry about that. I had this job interview.
You're having a job at the restaurant.
I'm gonna quit. I have this new job that pays way more.
That sounds great. What kind of job is it?
Well, I look after this kid.
Sounds like babysitting.
Sort of.
You make way more money babysitting?
Yeah.
Well, as long as you still have time to practice for the tournament. It's only a month away, you know, and we really need to win. And I really need to pay these bills.
Kira was there today, wasn't he? So is he going to invest in the dojo?
Who knows? First, he wants to make sure it'll be a success. Your Uncle Benny is good. He's come so close, but he's never trained a champion. Akira wants proof.
And why win the championship? That'll make the difference for Akira.
It might.
Brittany, you're going to be late for school.
I have nothing to wear.
So I see.
Daddy, I'm so excited. I don't know how I got you to change your mind, but anyway, I'm really glad you're letting me go to public high school. Like a regular kid. You won't be sorry.
I'm sure I won't. By the way, Brittany, how are you getting to school?
Isn't Niles going to drive me?
Well, he can, of course. But do regular kids go to high school in a limousine?
No, I suppose not. Who's ringing the door at this hour? Niles, there's someone at the door.
Well, since you don't have a driver's license...
Because you won't let me.
I thought the most regular thing would be for you to ride to school with a fellow student.
But I don't know anyone at Westridge High.
Well, I do. There's your ride to school.
You expect me to ride to school in that? Wait till they see Brittany's first day at school. Definitely different from her private school in the Sleuth Out. That'll be Friday, so everyone out there, don't forget to watch.
Now, singing their hot song, Coulda, Shoulda, Woulda. Here's the party!
Tony, you want to meet a friend of mine?
Sure.
Whoa.
Cute room.
Yeah.
Whose is this? Is this yours? Let me show you something. you know what this is? It's a real tarantula. Skin.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't know much about it, but our next guest does. Everybody, would you please welcome our preacher keeper, Warren Eckstein.
Warren, how cool. I would shake your hand, but tell me about this. Isn't this interesting? This is actually spiders like snakes will shed, and they shed everything, including their fangs. Those are the fangs right there. And the interesting part is this spider right here is what this came from just a couple of days ago. So that's the actual spider. So this was part of that spider not that long ago.
No idea.
My goodness. Now, Warren, bugs have a pretty bad rap. Do they serve any good purpose?
You know, no one likes bugs. No one has a good word to say about bugs or spiders, but every animal on this planet has a good purpose. For example, spiders eat certain insects, which would be harmful. Insects eat certain plants that would be harmful. So everything really does balance itself out in the long run.
What are they doing? I mean,
you know, these look funny. I noticed you all standing back when you're Tony. I know you're not a the thing to remember is that some are dangerous and some aren't. Let me give you an example. Here we have some scorpions. Everyone's afraid of scorpions.
Ooh, wow.
These are big scorpions. Fred, if you would just stick your hand in here, Fred.
Wait a minute, Fred,
please. Give me a minute.
Well, we go way back.
Wait. Trust me, Fred. Trust me. I can pick one of these up?
Sure you can.
Wait a minute.
How?
Right, there you go. Just like that. There you go. Just like put it back down. There you go.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Put it back down. Now that is...
He doesn't want to go back down. Warren. Oh.
Ah! Wait, go! An emperor scorpion. Now that isn't dangerous, Tony, but you asked me about danger. And over here, we have something called a Deathstalker scorpion. Now this little scorpion here is from Egypt, ancient Israel, and is very, very deadly. And one of the things that's interesting about scorpions, the smaller the claws, the smaller the stinger, the more deadly the scorpion is. So this little guy's deadly, that big guy, no problem whatsoever.
Yeah, you think it's the opposite.
You would think, but it's totally different that way. And tarantula is also a kind of interesting animal. A lot of people think tarantulas are deadly, deadly animals, and they're not really deadly. This tarantula, for example, is a Chilean rose tarantula, and if it were to sting you, which is pretty rare because these are pretty mellow, it's no worse than a bee sting or a wasp sting, and a lot of people do keep them as pets. Yet, there are other types of spiders that I would really not recommend too much at all. Let me give you an example. Here we have what's called a baboon spider. And this guy, baboon spider, and you're going to see that he is not the friendliest guy. You're going to see him here that he's not the friendliest guy in the world. So we're going to talk to him. See him? There he goes.
Whoa.
He's up on his hind legs. And you see those black things that I'm pointing to?
Yeah.
Those are the actual fangs where the venom would come from. So this one is not, again, the type that I would recommend. Yeah, I don't know what it means in tarantula, but he's definitely saying, leave me alone, Warren, quickly. So again, that's one you wouldn't want to have as a pet.
Now, what about cockroaches? They seem like they're everywhere, and we can't get rid of them.
Cockroaches have been around for millions of years, and I'm a firm believer that when the world ends, cockroaches will be around even then. Here I just happen to have some cockroaches with me.
These are puppies.
Now, these are not your average. Oh, cool. These are Madagascar hissing cockroaches. And we have our little bug from a little microphone. Because they do make some noise. If we can get them to make some noise, they will, but they're not going to. See how even cockroaches aren't that ugly, are they?
Huh? What good are cockroaches?
Cockroaches are kind of interesting because now they're using cockroaches to predict earthquakes. They put them in colonies and they react when there's going to be an earthquake. And when people see them react, they know there's a problem. Maybe that's the reason they've been around for so many millions of years is based on the fact that they can predict things like that.
Wow. So what about what is that thing?
These are Asian millipedes. Ooh. And a lot of people think millipedes have 1,000 legs, and the way it works is that they have 2 legs per segment body, and they can have up to 230, 300 different legs, but they don't actually have 1,000 legs. And these are kind of nice. They don't bite or anything.
They don't hurt you.
No, as a matter of fact, Lindsay, can I borrow your shoulder? There you go. Don't move. Stay. There you go. Isn't that great? What interesting animal.
Can insects be trained?
Can insects be trained? They really can't be trained like a dog or a cat. You're not going to walk it down the street. But if you have a tarantula and you handle it every day and you talk to it every day, it will get to know you. But again, it's not going to be tricks like sit up, give me a floor, and speak. Yeah. But they can be,
Some of these do make respectable pets.
They do. But the thing that you have to remember is you want to educate yourself first. In other words, if you're going to get a tarantula, make sure you know what you're doing. If you're going to get any of these animals, they can make good pets, but really study them first. And some people really become interested.
Well, they are fascinating animals. But next time, it's always great to have you here. Yeah. Next time, how about cats, dogs?
Puppies, kittens,
dogs. Yeah. Something like that. Yeah.
Warren, Lindsay, I've never seen you so still.
Yeah. This is your jewelry. Thank you very much. Everybody, thank you. Warren Eckstein, a big round of applause. Thank you for joining us.
To say goodbye to all my
you real soon.
Why? Because we like you.
The Disney Inn is the official hotel of the Mickey Mouse Club. It offers the best of all worlds, a relaxed family atmosphere in the very heart of the Walt Disney World Resort.